In this video, I'm going to show you a system for drawing multiviews that's based on something called descriptive geometry. Descriptive geometry was invented by a French mathematician. His name was Gaspard Monge. Here's his last name, M-O-N-G-E. And he thought all this stuff up probably in the late 1700s. So this has been around for a while. So let's imagine that you are trying to visualize the multiviews of this triangle right here. And so it's essentially, it's a plane. It has a slight thickness to it. So what I would do is look at all the possible views of it and then say, okay, my principal view, and that would be the one that would show me the most, I would probably draw that right there for my principal view. And so I'm going to go ahead and make a quick sketch of kind of what that principal view looks like. Something like that right there, right? And maybe I should have got this a little straighter across right there. And I can see that I have these three points that define that plane. I can label this point A, and this one B, and this one C over here, okay? Now, just for realism, I'll add in this little thing that's right here, that little cutout that's in there. Okay, so the way it works whenever you're trying to figure out what something looks like is that you want to rotate your object 90 degrees relative to the initial view that you have. And so here's how that works. If this is my front view, I want to go up here to this view at the top, because what I want to create is a top view, and I want to take that point and I want to rotate that toward me 90 degrees. And I want to keep it directly above this view right here. But you can see that what we end up with essentially is just a straight line that has a little bit of thickness to it, so it's actually going to be two lines on the edges. So if I do that same thing right here with B, or with point B, because it's the highest point, I would rotate this toward me and spin it 90 degrees. And so first thing I would do before I did that is I would lightly draw a construction line up from point A, and I would lightly draw a construction line straight up from B, and lightly draw a construction line straight up from C, like that. Then what I would do is I would add a line, just a horizontal line, between where my front view is going to be, my top view is going to be above that line right there. I would come out just a little ways past the edge of this line that I've constructed here, and I would just draw a vertical line. And then what I would do is go to point B, and I would project it straight across over to here. And you can see A and C are on the same line, so I'm going to draw those that way, like that. Okay, so my right side view is going to wind up over here, and my top view is going to wind up here. Now, what these lines here represent are what we call a fold line. And just trust me on this for right now. So what we're going to have in this area right in here, what we call this is our front view, but we actually call this a frontal view, like that. The top view that we're going to have in here, we're going to call actually a horizontal view. And the right side view, which is going to be over here, we're going to refer to it as a profile view. And Monge is the guy who thought this up. He would label this as like F, H, and P, except he was probably speaking French, and those words may not be the same in French. So we go back to looking at our object. We know when we rotate this top point 90 degrees toward us, we wind up with a straight line. That line has to fall between A and C up here. So I'm just going to draw a line straight across and give it a little bit of thickness and draw that across. Close up the ends on it like that. And right here where B goes up, there would be a little dark line coming across like that. And so if you wanted to, you could label that this edge right here is B, and this edge over here corresponds to A, and right over here this corresponds to C. All right, now here's a cool thing. You know this fold line that we just added in here? If we were to go to the corner of that fold line right there and sketch in a 45 degree line. Now it's important we sketch it in at 45 degrees. If we do any like 30 degrees or 15, it's not gonna work very well. It's gonna skew how we use this. But here's how we can use this line right here. First off, we call this a miter line. And what the miter line allows us to do is to project from our top view to our side view, or from our side view up and over to our top view. So here's what I would do. I would go to this front leading edge of that view, and I would just lightly project over until it crosses the miter line. And then I would go to the line above, and I would lightly project it across over here till it crosses the line. Then I would go to the points where it intersects, and I would project straight down like this, and I would project straight down like this. And so my right side view actually is going to land between those two lines that come down. So I'm going to darken these edges right here. And B actually projects across to right there. So this edge right here would be where B comes across. And this line down here actually represents A and C in my right side view. So this is the descriptive geometry method of determining what a front, a top, and a right side view would look like.